Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind for the Commodore Amiga. Now back into the test mine. I remember this. I must have had this text before. This is one of the few metal objects you have seen on the forest moon in the form... Yeah, I remember the "of" was missing, right? Of a massive lock that blocks your way into the mines. Well, we have a key. I mean, we have a key. I do remember that. Alright, so we gotta ask this guy for entrance. Now that we know the math problems, we can get through. Ugh. Melvin, if you do the honors. It's mine. I'm looking for, like, the highlighted words, but they're not highlighted anymore. I think gate is what we want. Thank you. Thank you. Closing behind me. You know, I'm not sure which one we go down, so let me try this one. It's closest. We'll just take a peek. If that's it. Yeah, that'll work. This one's closed off, so... We still have the egg, I trust. Otherwise, we'll have to fight all these groups of monsters. We do have both eggs. Where am I? Pretty much forward and, yeah, south. And then in here, I think. Hello, my friends. It's funny how they know we have the egg, even though it's hidden away in our inventory. Alright, so we're going down south here and then through there. Mostly east. Alright, I'm going this way. Alright, to that gate. I'm not sure. I think it's this ladder we want. Greetings. I know it was the last one we tried. It's funny. Yep, that's it. So I'll drink. And then, hold on, it's gonna itch and run away. Alright, so now that we know what these represent, see the last 5 episodes. Let me consult my notes. I keep having an itch, sorry about that. So the yellow means 50. The orange is 10. Although these look like different shades, don't they? Can I get even closer? Yeah. I don't know if they're different. Sometimes I wonder if they look a different color based on the angle we're looking at it. Or the lighting in here or something. I know there's no lighting effects back in games like this, but... Alright, so... I'd say 100, right? Yellow is 50. Orange is 10. So if these are both orange, then that's 70. And red is 1, so 71. Let's see if this is the number that it might want. Dust trickles out from the joints between the door as it opens slowly for the first time in ages. Sound better? Interesting. Stale air billows out around you. It smells old, age old. It is clear it has not been breathed by a living being for thousands of years. Well, then we shouldn't find any monsters down here, right? Otherwise, I cry foul. I mean, I don't mind fighting him, it just wouldn't make sense. Oh, we've got a pit here. Almost ran right into it. What bothers me the most is that I can't map the end of the corridor. Oh. I'm trying to levitate down. Yeah, I don't think... I think if we use a rope, we can go down with it without being hurt. But we only have one coil of rope, right? Just checking. Anyone else have any rope? I don't want to use our last rope. What if we really need it? We're stuck without it. Oh, here's 3 more ropes. Wait. Agile can carry a lot more. He can stack these ropes. Here, give that to him. That frees up Nelvin a little bit more. You can stack things. Always do. Okay. So since I have 4 of these, I'm gonna save anyway, just in case it doesn't bring us down and we try to go up again, like with the levitate. I don't wanna waste a rope. Even though we have 4 of them. Now we can go down without being hurt. Antique Area 1. What about the air in this place? Has this been breathed by a living being? Another door. Talk to the door. Anything on the wall that might open it? It might need to be powered. And then it would ask for a number, but there's no corresponding symbol here for that one. And it bothers me we can't just step over these rocks. Okay. I don't see a way through anything here. Oh, I doubt we can get through. I'm gonna try anyway. Maybe we can use the pickaxe on these rocks, maybe? Oh, this... is this... is that anything? Well, there's gotta be more to it than this, man. Maybe... I'll try to use the pickaxe over here. I'll try to use the pickaxe in a whole bunch of places. Ah! The collapsed piles of rock here are too loose to withstand the pickaxe. Sweet! What is that? I turned a lever. Did that open a gate? What did the lever do? See how anything changed. Unless maybe something changed above. See if we can, like, pass through these walls. No? Well, let's try the pickaxe a few more times, maybe? Face this way. I don't know if it matters which way you face when you do the use. I tend to think it doesn't actually matter. But I swear I was facing one way at one point recently. And it cleared something next to me. I think that was up above. With the gate that we... that first gate we were finally able to get through. Alright, what about this? Ah! Oh, okay. We've got another one. I figured we'd have to power this gate. Another amber piece. Some reason it's really picky how close we get to this thing. This apparatus too reacts to the piece of amber and begins to work. So exciting. Where's the gate? Oh, the gates. This way. Oh! That looks very dangerous. I gotta see what happens. I just got to. We all die. The flashes are terribly strong. Nigel dies. Did we... just... turn that on? This is back when I... still open that, yeah. Yeah. So what does that lever even do then? That switch, whatever? It doesn't control the lightning there. The jump spell, do we? Do we learn the jump spell? Jump. I have spell learning points 28. Hold on 1 second. It's like an alchemist, right? We want jump. We require 10 spell learning points. So maybe we're supposed to jump. This doesn't seem to. So maybe we want this switch on. For later. Oh, wait! Now it's off. So with the switch in the rightmost position was on, we had to turn it left and then back right. Shrug. I shrug at you. Could be that Ambermoon itself did not anticipate that. Okay, we've got a door with a math equation or number, and then we've got an open door. We've got a lot of these. We got a lot of these, what do you call it? Walls that look like they could be, you know, pickaxed apart. Almost looks like you can walk through in the middle of that, doesn't it? Ooh, but there's a treasure chest. the east. I can't even see it, but it must be there. It might not look like a traditional treasure chest, but I'm not going to hold that against him. Probably is another switch around here, as it might be in that other room. Let's try a few different areas here. I'm out in here. Almost looks like a button there, doesn't it? Boop. I'm trying to change direction when I didn't even... in anything here. Nothing! Try here. I tried over there. I don't know if I tried here. Let's make a little attempt. Okay. We haven't gone through the other door, so most likely there's something to be seen there. Alright, we can do math again, because we love math. Not really. Okay. So, as you recall, the circles are multipliers. So I don't know if we need to be following the equations, how they go in a certain sequence. A lot of people who don't know math equations get that wrong, like me. So the red is 1 and the orange is 10. So we've got 11, I guess, times 11. Which is 121, I think? Wait. Yeah, according to my calculator here, it is. Alright, so let's... try this. Oh, the door does not respond. Do I have it wrong, or does the door need to be powered? Unless it's 11... times 1, which is 11, and then 11 times 10, which is 110. Not respond. I tend to think, though, the door needs to be powered. Where's the power source? Wait. I haven't realized there was something over here. A skeleton. this just for show? Evidently. That stops us from walking. Maybe it's just for being annoying. Maybe it's just for being annoying. Alright. But I tend to think there's something hidden over here that could maybe be cleared with a pickaxe. So I'm facing north, and I'm using the pickaxe. Nothing. Well, the pickaxe don't get used up when you use them. Looking a lot of things I'm not meaning to. Let's see. Maybe this way. Well, this is a solid wall. I'll try over here. So where are we now? It looks like there could be an area. Facing east. Says no. Get closer. Can't get closer. Okay. Come on. I got to find the power source for the gate. Damn. Oh! No, no, no. Whatever. I burned a rope. I don't feel like doing this over. Well, you know what? Even though, I mean, when the gate is not powered, it doesn't ask you for a number, right? So it's got to be powered already by something. Maybe the other device that I put the amber in powers a few gates. So thereby I conclude that I've got the number wrong. But red and orange, R11, and you think we're multiplying it by 11? Unless we're multiplying it by 1 and then 10. I'm just looking at my notes here. And orange. Unless that's supposed to be yellow. In that case, it would be 51 times 51. Hold on. Which would be 2601. I don't think that's yellow, but I'm gonna try 2601 just in case that is it. The door does not respond. Unless I do just try the jump spell to get through here. Can I get a little closer? Probably. I have the Lich Crown on, I have unlimited read magic, so I should not fail at this at all anyway. Just in case, I did save. I'm glad I took all these with us. We have managed it. We have instant access. I just want to see something. First of all, move that. Spell learning points, only 18. I think the only spells I'd want to learn are ones currently in my inventory here. Remove curses. Oh, we already know levitation. That's probably taking that along just in case. An extra. Alright, I'm gonna save again. So I still have to learn the scroll again, because I don't know if this is gonna work. I've never used this spell. Jump. We made it through. Nice. Is that the treasure? Wait. Oh. Okay. Selena finds a strange object in the compartment in the wall. It reminds you, somehow, of a kind of book. Antique book. Nice. I like antique books. Let's hope it doesn't crumble to dust when we try to read it. I like how it... the little treasure chest, whatever you call it, disappears. I just want to take a cursory glance at this. 2500 grams. Alright, text scroll. The pages are full of incomprehensible symbols and characters which do not belong to any known language. Well, that's not very helpful. Nelvin knows a lot of languages, right? So it's not human, sylph, or animal. He does know elf, dwarvish, and gnomish, which the rest of us, well, us three. Felinic. Alright, let me see if Nelvin can make any sense of this. I kinda doubt it, but we gotta try. Alright. Just in case it's in Felinic. Alright, none of us know what this does, or is, what it says. So. Not very helpful, I'm afraid. Although that wall is very suspect, isn't it? This one's a little bit as well. That's all we found in here? So now we're stuck again. I think I really like that spell. That's a way to get over the trap door above. Here, right? Where's the hole? Can we not get back up? Oh, here it is. No failings. At least we have to finish the map out. What about here?